Morning, it's Debbie from Home Bodies Fitness. Today I'm going to be circuiting between my indoor cycle and my rower, my water rower, using music from DJ Brandon Wade on my SoundCloud. I'm just clipping in. The clip on the right side is a new clip, so it's a little picky. All right, so here we are. We're going to start with light resistance on the wheel. Make sure you've got your clocks on, your timers on. We're going to start with a nice easy ride. Relax the shoulders, upper body nice and relaxed. I'm going to turn on my little computer. It will take a second here. My shoulders are relaxed, fingers are relaxed. I'm full-footed on my pedal stroke. Right now, my RPMs are somewhere between 80 and 90 RPM. If you don't have a computer, something that tells you your RPMs, there's a great app called MotoSumo, which you can connect to your bike just with your phone. All right? So try that app. And if you have somewhere where you are now, we're again 80 to 90 RPM, just getting started here. The entire time, my shoulders are going to be relaxed, my elbows are soft, fingers are relaxed. Slow, easy breaths. So I'm going to keep moving my little iPad on my bike here. My hands are in overhand position. I will use mostly spinning terminology. Position one, two, three, and two and a half. Right now, in this warm-up, let's add a turn of resistance, but not slow down. So just enough to feel. I'm moving my hands out into the hook of the handlebars. And just while we have this light resistance on the wheel, I'm going to increase my speed by about 5 RPMs. Three, two, pick up. That's it. Just enough to feel. Not going crazy. We're in our warm-up. Eight, seven, six, five. I'm going to bring it back down to the original RPM in three, in two, back it down. Back to that 80, 90 RPM. Stay relaxed. How are we doing, guys? It is Wednesday hump day, or pump day as it's known in my circles. Add a little resistance on the wheel. Don't slow down. So I'm going to be doing about 15 minutes here. I'm going to transfer myself to the rower and I'll get back on. So if you're fortunate enough to have both, I hope you'll join me. Pick up your RPMs by five. That's it. Keep those legs going. Try not to bounce on your saddle. Try to stay controlled. Hang in there. Eight more counts. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three. Back it off to your original 80, 90 RPM. Stay relaxed. One more time, we're going to add resistance on that wheel. I'm still staying somewhere between 80 and 90 RPM for now. As I load the resistance on the wheel, I'm going to make my way to about 80 RPM. So, load a little more resistance on that wheel. Begin to hold that 80 RPM. Reach your hands to the end of your handlebars, hips up. So here we're going to be somewhere between 60 and 80. And even when I hit the saddle to push a little harder, I'm going to maintain that pace. So when I hit the saddle, my max is 80 RPM. Three, two, in the saddle, push. So if you're going beyond 80 RPM, just add resistance to the wheel. Push it. Out of your saddle. Recover. Now I'm somewhere between 60 and 80 RPM again. I know my bike is a little uneven this morning. Hang in there with me. I'm finding myself somewhere around 65, 70 RPM. I'm going to go back to the saddle, and I'm going to push towards 80. 3, 2, saddle push. Push a little harder. Hang in there. Four. 3, 2, out of the saddle, recover. Catch your breath. Now, the question is, can you do this and add resistance to the wheel without slowing down, without losing your breath? Hang in there, guys. We're going back in the saddle. In 3, 2, 1, bring it down. Push, pull. Finding the rhythm of this sound. 1, 2, 1, 2. Good. Hands are in hand position 2, 2.5, with our arms right around the hook. 60, 70 RPM. We'll stay in the saddle for this one. If you need to get out, please do. That's it. Find that rhythm. 1, 2, 1, 2. Give me 2 to 5 RPM increase. 3, 2, 1. Pick it up. Back off your pace. Go back to 1, 2, 1, 2. There you go. 1, 2, 1, 2. Keep going. Push, pull. Front and back of the legs. Same question. Can you maintain this pace and add resistance? Even if it's just a small little change up. Hang in there. All right, we're going to take off a little bit more. 2 to 5 RPM. 3, 2, 1, go. Stay in control. Back it off. 1, 2. Out of the saddle. Good. We're going to be here for a few more moments and hit the saddle again. 1, 2, 1, 2. Brings us to about 70 RPM. Out of your saddle, hands in 3. Now we hit the saddle Increase your speed. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Pick it up. Four, three, two, out of the saddle, bring it back. Keep going. Back in the saddle last time. 3, 2, 1, go.
Let go of the resistance. All right, guys. So I turned it so I hear the music and you get to hear me. Lucky you. All right, so turn your resistance left. Push down on your brake. Come on out. If you can join me on the rower, join me on the rower. If not, stay on your bike and enjoy the ride. I'll be here for a few moments. I'm gonna take everything with me. I can use my team shoes because they're very recessed. And I'm gonna row my first 1,000 meters with a moderate resistance or moderate speed, 24 to 26 strokes per minute. I'm going in 3, in 2, let's go. That's it. Push. That's it. Nice smooth strokes. The power is on the push out. The pull is about 20% of it. So the legs are about 60%. The core and the arms are about another 20% each. So you can see where your power comes from. I'm at about 24 strokes per minute here. Now, if you have a rower, but you don't have a bike, stay with this. I'm looking to bring down my split times. How long it takes me to row 500 meters, right? Right now, I'm warmed up from the bike, but I'm not really warmed up in the same way with my body on the rower. So I'm gonna make this a little less intense, which means my split times will be a little higher. Long reach, nice smooth push. If I wanna go faster, all I do is bring the release a little sooner. If I wanna slow it down, kind of pause at the back. That's it. Now, if you're with me and you're doing that 24 to 26 and you're at the low end, when you find 500 meters, maybe push a little harder. Don't go faster, push a little harder. Push it to the limit. So if you start to push through your legs a little bit more, you're gonna find that stroke time going down, that split time. Good. So your second half of your 1,000 meters will be a little bit more challenging. More powerful. Split times down. My stroke stays the same speed-wise. My form stays the same. I still push back with my legs. Pull with my arms and core. Legs, core, arms. Arms, core, legs. The pull is not the primary move. It's the push. So I see a lot of this, right? Going faster, not getting full strokes, inefficient. I also see a lot of legs coming in first, so you have to raise your arms. Let those legs come in last. Legs out first, legs out last, or legs in. You got this, guys. Now, when we all hit our 1,000 meters, let's do a little recovery time in an oblique row. So I'm about 150 meters off. My slower time, because I started out with little power. Good. Good. So I've got about 50 meters to meet my 1,000, and then I'm gonna recover. All I got is 5. Good, now I'm gonna recover for about 60 seconds here, rowing side to side. You don't have to change this grip. You can stay in a regular row. Just slow it down. Catch your breath. Good. So we're gonna do another 500 meters, not 1,000, 26 to 28 strokes a minute. A little harder, right? A little faster, which will make it harder, but not sloppy. So we're gonna go in 30 seconds. We'll do 500 meters. So just kind of pay attention to where you're starting, what your starting number is. From wherever you are, add 500 meters. In 3, 2, 1. Good, now we're gonna up the speed, 26 to 28 strokes. That means I spend less time at the back and I'm still trying to introduce power to my legs. That's it. Depending on your speed, depending on your power, that will make the determination in your split times. Good. You got this, guys. Whenever it is that you reach your 500 meters, do a recovery row again. I still have about 300 meters as I'm not pushing my hardest right now. But I'm keeping my smooth stroke. Moderate power, because I know that I'm going back on the bike. So I don't want to burn out before I complete my workout. Keep it going. Good. All right, if you haven't reached your limit, can you put a little more power without going faster? Good. When you're done, recover There you have it. All right. One more. 250 meters. If you want to stop and set your computer, go ahead and do that. 250 meters. With your most intensity, because the song that I'm hearing in my ears is Danger Zone. All right? So, we're gonna get started with that 250. Three, two, go. Speed up to 32. Power your most. So what we did here, we were going longer with less intensity. Every time we shortened it, we increased intensity until we got to this point. Go for it, guys. Power. Don't go sloppy. Keep it going. Now you could be doing the same thing on a bike, right? You can do the same thing in a run. So if you're not with a rower, go ahead, stay on that bike and keep doing this. Keep it going. I think I went past my limit. So I'm gonna recover. Whew. All right. Good. All right, gang. I'm gonna rack my oars. I'm gonna take my feet back out and I'm gonna head back onto my bike. At which point I'm gonna leave you and I will see you tomorrow. Join us on my YouTube channel as well as on Homebodies Fitness and Yoga on Facebook. Have a great day. Stay home.